Hello everyone, I have got a very special project for you today. I'm going to be discussing the Blue Energy One chip, why you should use it, and how in the heck an FCC-approved BLE module costs less than $3. But first, let's go back a couple months to when I discovered the EMB1061 from MXChip. This module costs $2.60 from DigiKey, a US seller, and can get to $1.60 from Alibaba on large orders. That is insanely cheap compared to similar modules that cost $7 and up. It has 160 kilobytes of flash, 24 kilobytes of RAM, an integrated Cortex M0 processor, lots of peripherals, easy over-the-air updating, and a built-in voltage regulator. So why isn't this thing taken off? Well, two words. Terrible support. But before I get into that, I'm going to go over some things that really make the EMB1061 shine, and make an argument as to why you should use it in your projects. Number one is simply the price. You just can't find an FCC-approved low-energy Bluetooth module for less than $5. Sure, the ESP32 exists, and it has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth and two cores, but that thing is a power-hungry beast. I defy you to make it last more than a year on a single coin cell battery. Which brings me to the power consumption. This chip has an onboard voltage regulator that allows it to run from 1.7 to 3.6 volts and has some extremely low power modes that will allow it to run for years on a single coin cell, no sweat, with regular advertisements and data transmission. In fact, the current usage while transmitting is 8.3 milliamps. Compare that to an ESP32 device with transmission current up to 130 milliamps for BLE. That's not really low energy if you ask me. That's not even factoring in the external losses from voltage regulators and boosters that would be needed for 3.3 volts exclusively to the ESP32. Other than that, this chip has a small footprint that is easily soldered by hand, pre-programmed MAC addresses, and even more enticing features. Just look at this datasheet. So I'll ask the question again, why hasn't this module taken off in the hobby space? And again, the answer is the same as I said before. Terrible support. ST essentially locks this product behind a paywall, forcing hobbyists to either bite the bullet and pay upwards of $1,500 a year, or use an IDE that doesn't even officially support it anymore, and never supported debugging in the first place. Not only that, but countless people have tried and asked questions regarding how to use this chip, only for questions to be no longer available, or more commonly, simply unanswered. So how do we as a hobbyist community come together to skip the paywall and unlock the full potential of the EMB1061 and Blue Energy chip? I started putting together a custom tool chain about 2 months ago. Over that time, I've spent more than 80 hours working on hardware, debugging firmware, and trying to bodge my way into something that works. And surprisingly enough, I was actually able to get a tool chain working. It has full debugging support and works fairly well, and it's only a little bit hackish. So that's where you guys come in. I'm looking for people to help with this project and make it something usable for everyone. Right now it's still pretty difficult, but if you're up for the challenge of developing for this chip, debugging issues in the tool chain, and cleaning up the project, well, there's a GitHub link in the description. I'm also selling development boards essentially at cost that allow the module to be easily breadboarded and used. If you want to support this project, consider picking one up. It's a heck of a lot easier than putting one of these jank boards together. In any case, I'll be uploading more videos on how to set up and use the toolchain, and I'll have additional links and resources in the description for getting started. You can also join the Discord linked in the description, where we will be supporting and developing the chip. Thank you all for listening to this short introduction, and I hope to see your pretty faces working on this alongside me. Thank you.